The lifeblood of the Allied effort in World War II was the convoy system that delivered men and material to the various theaters of war. This story is about the Naval Armed Guard, the sailors who manned the guns and protected the merchant vessels that made up the Atlantic and Arctic convoys. This is the story of Gun Crew 256.
Gun Crew 256, when you start to look at it, is an unbelievable story.
The country needs them. They take whatever duty is given to them. And believe me, nobody, I don't think, would pick the Arctic convoys as their first choice.
The convoys were a real problem to muster and to shepherd across the ocean.
When it came time to get things done, things got done.
That battle of the Atlantic, that is the longest battle of the war.
You look at the year that they were together, it was very harrowing.
Three mines floated within 30 feet of our ship.
It's critical that ships hold their position, keep the convoy together.
They dropped 25 more depth charges.
I'm sure there was a rather sinking feeling.
Their job was, as gunners, protection of the ship.
They were shooting off flares at night, enemy aircraft all around.
It was duty, it was their job.
I can't imagine losing all communications, having the vessel getting its butt kicked, and then you gotta worry about a German sub. It's just got to be insane.
And however gallant they were, they would very quickly be overwhelmed.
U-402 puts a torpedo into her with tragic results. As she starts to go down, panic really does set in.
They were in 60-foot seas. You're going to run out of food if you're going to run out of water.
Two-thirds of the ships in that convoy were lost.
535 folks on board the Mallory, 202 survived.
I don't think my grandmother ever got over it, or my grandfather.
I think for my grandfather to survive that is a miracle.
It was probably the biggest single Allied convoy disaster of the war.
When America calls, it's guys like those members of Crew 256. They went out there, they put themselves on the line. I think that's a remarkable thing.